Hello and welcome to Tom's Travel Log Blog Video Diary, coming to you here from Southeast London. As you see, I have decided to shave my beard off during lockdown, which explains why I may look a little strange. What follow is special edition travel log blog video. Please sit back, relax and enjoy the Corona Virus Video Log Blog Diary, the movie. Thanks for watching, love you and goodbye.
Alexa, turn on my rock lamp lounge. Oh, can't even fucking see my face.
Hello and welcome to Greg's Corona Diary.
Hello there.
Welcome to Vicky's Corona Diary.
Ben's Corona Log Blog Video Blog Diary thing.
What have you found? You've got your hat on.
Welcome from the Gold Coast, that is of Northern Ireland.
Good morning and welcome to Nash's Corona Adventures.
Oh, he's doing weird video diaries.
If you like that, everyone, head on over to the website hdpiano.com, where the other parts are all there for your perusal.
Bitch. Hey, this is Blake's coronavirus diary thing. I don't know what to do with bad haircuts, mandatory showers are optional, quick clean clothes not essential. Yeah, it's a good day. It's just hard out here, pretty much all alone, and just don't have many people to speak to. Like, I got a few friends here though. I just get good vibes off him and stuff. Me and George's a pretty cool bloke. He doesn't talk much, but he's very like introspective. But
hey, George.
Okay, that was rude. Come and say hello to Nikki. Come on, come and say hello. Oh, fuck you, please. I'm sorry. Okay.
Good morning, welcome to Ross's Corona Diaries. Here I am in my natural element, beside the coffee machine as a chief barista at Red Bull Racing. This really is the peak and, well, limit of my capabilities, providing all the coffee to the staff. I'm going to take you through a bit of a training exercise here and how I go about this process. Cheers, Nikki.
Hello, and welcome to
Greg's Corona Diary. Ugh. It's been a whole week, and now today I get to go shopping for the first time. Yay, I can't wait to meet people with Corona. Hey.
I've now got out of bed. I'm just going to put on my Corona outfit, and I'll be good to go shopping. Let's do some bulk buying.
Welcome to Greg's Corona Diary. This is me shopping. There's the wife having a go at me as fucking usual.
Here is a successful even trip to Tesco.
Look at the green dogs.
And the wine. And the brunch.
That's one way to go for it.
Hello and welcome to Vicky's Corona Diary. As you can see, I haven't washed my hair for a few days, not going strong on the makeup front, but hey, it's all right. I thought I'd show you around my tropical garden. Birds, slightly dead looking plants in my garden. This one's alive. Nikki, I think the tree you gave me could be this one. Christmas tree, remember? Garden mirrors, always need a garden mirror. This surface is good for dancing. Small gnome. Back in the house. not as tropical in the UK as it was in Australia. The issue I've got is, dun dun dun, not much going on in the fridge. Basil. Telephone. It's not a log, vlog, whatever diary. This is my Corona diary. Adios.
Hello and welcome to Jacques' Corona diary with Jazz. As you will be able to see, one noticeable difference from my time in quarantine is that I've shaved off all of my hair, which is quite drastic, I know, but it is a result of being locked up for 2 weeks. Isn't that right, Jazz? So, today, what have I been doing today? I have done sweet fuck all.
Who's this going to?
It's going to my fans, Jazz, yeah? So, there is a picture of Jazz and I when I had hair and was probably a bit slimmer before the days of F1. Anyway, today I have been painting this wall behind me white. And no one's gonna save you from the beast about to strike. You know he's dead. You ask what colour it was before. It was white. And it's taken about 16 coats, which has been stressful to say the least. Can you see I've got paint all on me, on my watch, on my glasses?
Are you feeling me?
This bedroom. So I've got my Johnston's white paint, which we got from B&M, which is quite naughty because you're only meant to go out for essentials and paint is not essential. But hey ho, desperate times call for desperate measures. These are my trays of paint, which as you can see make a fucking right mess, but it is what it is. You want to pay a price for the job that you do. Haven't fallen any harbours in the 2.5 weeks I've been in quarantine. And tonight, because I've run out of beer, I'm drinking a gin and tonic. So cheers and speak to you maybe again this evening, to be honest.
Yeah, and we also have some new friends here. Shut up, you little bitch.
Why don't you go get me a nice big can of soda pop?
You're gonna be lunch soon, you little fuck.
I feel bad saying that. Bye, guys. Wave goodbye. Bye. Why are you looking at me like, don't fucking death stare me, motherfucker. I'll fucking end you, cunt.
Little bitches.
What the fuck?
They're coming after me. They're legit coming after us. Stay back. Stay back. They listened. Yeah, little shop today. Been doing the IGA shout out. What? It's actually really good. And also it looks like this. There's nobody here. Trying to maintain a pretty healthy diet on things to keep up a lot of veggies. Greens, just white meats for the moment. Yeah, just fresh produce, being in like country areas and stuff. Trying to make those little wings on areas where we can, and you know, really important stuff. Fuck, it's definitely good shit.
Look at the abandoned streets of Wolverton. Can't see a thing.
Today, I'm chilling with the moo cows.
Say hello, moo cows.
One of them's pissing.
One of them's pissing.
Hello, fella.
Look at him go. Let's do a little toilet roll update. We are down to 13 toilet rolls in there. Unlucky for some, but very good for my bot.
Hey, welcome to the drug blog thing. Anyway, there's a bit of contention out there about whether Nikki's mum has gone overboard, but
This is not a time to fuck around. This is not a time to fuck around. This is where I've got my little stash kept. Little fucking secret compartment in here. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And if shit really gets serious, we've got some emergency backups here. Not a time to fuck around, people.
Hello, and welcome to Greg's Corona Diary. Today it is scorching hot, and I need a beer. So what we got in the old fridge today? Let's have a little look. I want one of these. Cheers. It's so damn good. Greg's Corona Diary today is in association with... Rudolph!
It's pretty hard, just feeling a bit claustrophobic and just enjoying the simple things, you know, a bit of coffee and stuff in the morning, and just trying to make the most of the cramped spaces and stuff, and but you're getting through, just it'll be all right.
Yeah, hey Nick, just came to check the mail and stuff, but yeah, nothing. No one wants to say g'day or check in, so yeah, feeling pretty lonely and stuff, but it's all good. I'll just head back to the house and just get on with the day, but
WWE Hall of Famer, Hacksaw Jim Duggan from the golden age of wrestling. And I got a special shout out for my friend Nikki over there in Australia. I know you're isolated because of the virus, as we all are all over the world. But anyway, hang tough. I hope you get a chance to catch out the WWF Network. Check out Legend House. Roddy Piper was my roommate, God bless him. I could get away with anything. I blame it on Piper. Anyway, Nikki, I hope you're still watching the show. I know it's not as good as the old days, but it's still a pretty good product. Anyway, thanks for being a wrestling fan. Hang tough down there in Australia. This virus, we're going to beat it, tough guy. Nikki, this hoe's for you. Ho!
Hello, and welcome to Nash's Quarantine Affairs. Good morning, and welcome to Nash's Corona Adventures.
Hi, and welcome to Nash's Quarantine Adventures Diaries.
Hello, and welcome to Nash's Quarantine Adventures.
Hello,
good
and
morning.
Good morning, and welcome to Nash's Corona Diaries.
Carol fucking Baskin.
Hi, and welcome to the first inaugural debut premiere episode of Nash's Quarantine Diaries. Sunday evening here, 9 o'clock at night. This is what's going on currently. Fucking esports is what it is. It's basically an absolute shit show of a program. Two geeky guys who, the thing I can't work out, have gone into the Gfinity Arena. How that's essential travel and essential work, I'm not quite sure when, you know. Out of that Saturday night takeaway last night, they didn't go because it wasn't essential travel. It was so bad. Dog's fast asleep. I'll have a more exciting episode tomorrow. It's not probably the best one to kick off with, but I want to show you how fun my Sunday's evenings in quarantine covering esports gets. Anyway, I'll speak to you all tomorrow, fans. You know, it's stay safe. Stay home, wash your hands, keep 2 meters apart, do one bit of exercise a day, and Stay gnarly, kids.
Time for a walk, out and about, making use of our 1 hour.
Here we are, out on a little walk in the countryside. This is about as much countryside looking as you get in Lewisham. Out with the little fella. Hi, Fox. What have you found? You've got your hat on. You have got your hat on.
We're going to go to the park. We're going to go down the high street. You're going to get sun in your eyes, which you're going to hate.
Look at your hairdo.
Yeah, it's been a nice day today. Look at the blue sky. Can't beat it.
I'm going for a walk today. Is it no fun?
Walking past graveyards to remind us of the doom and gloom that's going on in the world right now. So I think there's some doom and gloom there in a hat. Walking quickly, turning away, not wanting to be filmed.
Yeah, this is pretty much how the day pans out. We go for a walk, we go home, we go to sleep, we get something to eat, we go to the shop, we go to bed. Hello. What's up?
It's Saturday morning. It's about 7 minutes to 10 and I'm on a dog walk with Bella. Just near where I live. It's lovely blue skies.
I don't know what else to say, really. Give you a bit more footage.
Lori's just about to go past. There we go, he gave a little beep. Good lad.
What's the matter? What do you want, Fox?
Sarah's working today, so that's why I'm on my own on this walk.
Still walking.
But yeah, hope everyone stays safe, stay at home, and stay gnarly, kids.
This is Linda Lloyd's Corona Diary. The church here, which I was just telling you about, which George Gilbert Scott was designed, has got a Victorian school at the back. And it's still used today for art classes and obviously a few weddings. The church is not very big. It's got the most beautiful font in it, which was put there in remembrance of Maple's two daughters that died, which is lovely. Oh, we've got the owl box behind as well, which Peter put up there.
It's very pretty here. Not so bad.
And in front of us, we've got Forge Cottage, where the estate Forge used to be, which is where my friend Eleanor lives with her two little ones and husband.
Say goodbye.
Oh, and we're going to come to Chilli Greenhouse, which is where Leslie lives. Oh, look. Isn't that lovely? In the window.
The welcome back to Jack's Corona Diary. Just thought I'd update you all. Just had my engineer Luggy on the radio telling me I'm purple in sectors 1 and 2. Really is amazing what power I can generate out of these little
legs. Eat my dust!
Y'all might be wondering where I'm headed. I'm heading one place and one place only. And that's Carol fucking Baskins. Oh yeah, yeehaw!
Hi, konnichiwa. This is my COVID-19 diary. I'm about to go for cycling. But I'm going to take this water bike and then I'm going to go for cycling.
So far, I'm pedalling 42 minutes.
Took us all the way to this river. Very pretty. I've done 22 miles in less than 2 hours. Not too bad.
stay safe, everybody. Stay positive. Enjoy the sunshine.
Hello and welcome to Nash's Quarantine Diaries. This is my new look, I think, for the rest of 2020. I really like it. I think it's strong. It has an element of suave, an element of sophistication, with a little bit of intelligence added on the side. Sarah really likes it. She says she's never found me more attractive in the 10 years that we've been together. There's not much else to say. This is about it. This is about it at the moment. So stay safe, stay home, wash your hands, and stay gnarly, kids.
Thank those of you who are staying at home, thereby helping to protect the vulnerable and sparing many families the pain already felt by those who have lost loved ones.
The Taoiseach Leo Varadkar has re-registered as a doctor and will work one shift a week.
Hey, welcome to GMGM's Corona Diaries. Was that good Aussie accent? I can't believe I am doing a piece to camera. I absolutely hate doing this kind of stuff, but it's for a good cause because I hear you're in quarantine in a hotel room. It sounds awful. So I'm doing a little video diary from Josh's parents' holiday home in Norfolk. So we kind of decided to come down here for a long weekend before lockdown. So just brought pajamas and like just comfy clothes. And we've now been here on lockdown for 3 weeks, so this is as good as it gets. At least I brought my slippers. What have I been doing? I've been doing some yoga. Namaste. And I've also been doing some gardening. I never ever thought that I would do gardening, but I absolutely loved it. Just put my, Josh's dad's crops on. Yay! So what we did power hosing, and I accidentally power hosed the grass, so we've totally damaged that. But the rest of the garden looks pretty cool. Look how clean this slate is. This is the gin terrace. And then apparently we need to do these bushes next, but I can't really be asked for that. It's a lot of effort.
Yeah, not that bad. I'm now cleaning my makeup brushes with things I didn't even know I had.
Hey, Nikki, how's it going? Here you're stuck in the old quarantine as you re-entered the country. Well, you know, that's Australia for you. Don't know what you're up to, but probably playing a bit of Sims, knowing you. Anyway, hope you enjoy your time in lockdown and use it well. You know, I'm the same old, stuck in, watching a lot of box sets and basically driving the family mad. But that's life. Just got to deal with it. Peace out.
So this is my favourite seat to work from in the house. It's a nice little window seat, so you can watch everybody walking past. There's no TV here, which is a little bit weird, but we've been playing loads of card games by the fire. The fire's not on, but I also learned how to light that the other day. Pretty cool skill to have.
Right. I'll settle us in for the evening.
This is where all of our alcohol is kept. Ooh, woo, 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 yes! And then we've got a Sunday roast in the oven that we're going to eat before I watch the virtual Grand Prix tonight. How exciting! But yeah, that's it for me. Peace out!
Morning, Nikki. Welcome to Marcus's coronavirus diary. First thing in the morning. First of 1,000 bottles into this thing. Yeah, this is where I spend quite a lot of my time, actually, in the garage. Just standing here, really. Away from the kids, away from the missus. Just self-isolating in a self-isolation environment. Just a garage recluse. It's tidy, though. I tidied it up. I just stand here. Standing here for hours. Not doing anything, just standing.
must go shopping.
You okay, hun?
Morning, welcome to Marketers Coronavirus Log Blog.
And this is what I'm greeted to.
<laughs> 12 hours a day. No. Can I just finish talking to the camera now? So I'm doing a video message.
What for?
Come and have a look. Nikki, she's stuck in isolation. Say hello.
Hello.
And that's basically Marcus's coronavirus diary. It summarises how my life's been for the last 2 weeks, just constantly being interrupted by children. And how's homeschool going, Oliver?
Good.
Oh, excellent. Have you got anything to add, Oliver?
Nah.
Nah. We're good. All right, take care, Nikki. Oliver, can you push the red button, please?
Wash your hands, people. Stay safe.
Look at all that corona out there acting up as white clouds in the sky.
Hello there, welcome back to the Corona Diary. Boredom has, yeah, really started to set in now. I wanted to show you a little something I've been working on here. I thought I'd do something, productive. So what I've decided to do is take the bottle cap from every beer that I've drank so far in isolation and collect them. Not a bad effort. I'm joking. I have not drank that many beers. These have been collected over a period of many, many years. Got these little magnet thingies, which I ordered on Amazon. And I've, as you can see, I've got this little TV unit here, which is magnetic. What a great way to display my collection of bottle caps from around the world. It's going to be quite difficult to do two-handed here, but basically you just take two of these. They're very magnetic, as you can see. Okay, I can't actually, it's almost annoying. It's actually very difficult to do with one hand, but anyway, if we get two of these bad boys off. Two magnet thingy there. We'll pick our bottle cap. Let's go with this one. Every single one of these caps are unique. Collected them over a long sort of period. So you just get that and you see they're very magnetic, like that. And it just goes, bang, on she goes. And this is probably killed a solid like couple of hours of my isolation time. So, but as you can see, still quite a few to go there. So, yeah, better crack on. Thanks for watching the blog thingy. Travel. Yep. Yeah. Cool.
May the force be with you.
Hey Nikki, another day of Marcus's garage action. Hiding in here for another 6 or 7 hours before I'm seriously missed inside. Hope you're well. Speak soon. And that's pretty much. That's pretty much it from me.
Hello and welcome to Nash's Quarantine Adventures with today's special guest, Sarah. We're currently out on our one exercise of the day, walking the dog. Currently walking up a hill near us called Barleythorpe Hill. Bit of a view. What a lovely morning. It's about 10 degrees, something like that. Gonna get hot later. Gonna pop to a little farm shop, get a couple of essentials. Yes, nice day, isn't it? So, hope everyone's staying safe, staying at home, washing your hands, and stay gnarly, kids.
Say, this is Tallulah's lockdown diaries. Can you say that?
No.
Say, Tallulah's lockdown diaries.
No.
Please. Family's lockdown
diaries.
So video blog walk diaries. When we started doing this walk, those little things are tiny little dots, and now they're beautiful little gorgeous things, and every day they come over to see us, don't they? And they're getting bigger and bigger.
When in one day over the hills and stuff.
And this is where we stop for our chocolate or snack every day.
I'm a washing machine.
I
Hiya, this is a message from your old friend Nicola in Australia, or as I like to call her, Tricky Nikki. Hi Nikki, I hope you're doing well during the confinement and, you know, things aren't going too bat crazy, you know. A lot of people are losing the plot, as you can see. It hasn't affected me one little bit. I do miss Australia though, you know. Oh, those moments like going into the Jim Rose Circus dressing room backstage at the Melbourne Comedy Festival to the sound of butterflies being eaten by a blue jigsaw tattooed man called the Enigma. I'm gonna forget moments like that. But I do miss you, and I hope that we see you soon. But anyway, I've got a rush because I'm playing catch with my little friend. And remember, stay gnarly. Like Charlie Barley. It's a true character, look it up. Now, if you like the video, go and tell all your friends and spread the word. My name's Danny John Jules. If you didn't, my name's Idris Elba. Good day. Not you.
Welcome to my COVID-19 shutdown diary. We're here in Milton Keynes here. You see our lovely apple trees that have been growing. Right, I'm going to show you some exciting things we've been up to. First off, the boys here have taken to playing with sticks.
Hello.
Yeah, so sticks. We're also starting to measure the grass and see how well that is growing. So
it has grown 10.2 centimetres.
Oh, I think that is
That is about 2 millimetres bigger than yesterday, so that's quite a growth. I think that's because it rained a little bit and we had a bit of sun as well. We have also started growing our own vegetables. Boys, do you want to come and help me show?
We have some, I think, cabbage.
Yeah.
Here we have some
something.
Two sets of peas.
Peas.
And also some pumpkins.
But under here
is a den.
It's not finished and probably just looks a bit dark. Daddy's going to come down here for some beers.
Beer? Beer! We've been recording for 33 minutes.
Bye bye!
Hello and welcome back to Ross's Corona Diaries. I'm here in the kitchen, just in the door from a run, gonna make a little bit of banana bread with an Irish twist. Check in later on to see how it goes. Right, so here we are, done most of the preparation. You can see here, got the mix and then the little Irish twist, good dollop of butter, broken up chocolate, and we put a shot of instant coffee as well. Just to add into the mixer. There we go. With some chocolate, some butter. Bang that in. Look at that. Lovely. Absolutely lovely. Bang this boy around. Here we go. Got the shot of coffee in there. Now the mix is ready to go. Do you want some? Do you want some? Right. 50 minutes to turn this into a masterpiece. Have fun.
Here's the story of a lovely lady who was bringing up three very lovely girls. All of them had hair of gold, like their mother.
There we go, we're cooking. And there you have it. An absolute masterpiece from the one and only Ross Vaughan. Look at that.
Ice, ice, baby.
Hi Nikki, it's my Corona Log blog, and I promised you guys a tour of the murder shed. Now's the moment, hang on. Here we are in the murder shed. I've uncovered the mower.
I don't really know what that is.
I think that's a hedgehog.
Oh, God.
There's some spiders webs. I think there's a drop bear.
My lovely little shed. Might as well get a Chesterfield, the toilet and the bed. It's the only place where I can go.
Okay, so I forgot to put the mower away. So I'm going to go into the murder shed at night. I'm not sure this is a good idea. Holy shit. What's that noise?
Hey Nikki, it's Martin here from Homes of the Hammer. Oh my gosh, what is going on with you? Stuck in quarantine. What a nightmare. Well, I'm sure you can't wait to get back to Australia, playing Sims and Pet Rescue. And you go back to a beautiful part of the world, Sydney and all kinds of stuff. So I just hope that the lockdown is all right and hope you're coping okay with it. And that before long you'll be out into that autumn Australia sunshine. So listen, bear with it. And trust me, on the other side of the world, we're all going through it. I'm sure you know that. Don't know if that makes you feel any better. But listen, lots of love from me. I hope that they allow you lots of that lovely Australian wine in quarantine. Quarantine, is it lockdown? Well, whatever it might be. To hopefully get you through it. And hopefully it won't be too many more days before you're out. So lots of love from me in the meantime.
Hiya, welcome to my lockdown blog. Today I'm going to be making, well, a Lancashire butter pie, because the only thing left in my bloody fridge is potatoes and butter. Wish me luck.
Well, I'm pleased I didn't time-lapse that. I've gone through so much pastry. I would go as far as to say there's been a pastry massacre. I mean, it's killed my kitchen. But there is a pie, and that's quite exciting. So, it's pretty decent considering it's only got potatoes, apples, butter, an onion in it. That's pretty much all there was left in my fridge. So I'll take that, see how it comes out the oven.
Genuinely quite excited. This is the first thing I've ever made a pastry that actually doesn't look shit. Look at him.
Look at him. I'm so proud. Oh, he's like a child. I don't know how I'm gonna eat the bugger. Oh, butter pie. Cheers.
Good morning and welcome to Nash's Corona Diaries.
It's
9:13 and I've done my long arduous commute down the stairs to work. Thought I'd update you today on what I wear to work at home. I know a lot of people, you know, maybe probably don't get showered, don't get dressed, stay in their pyjamas all day, but unfortunately I'm not one of them. So I get up, so when Sarah gets up, she gets up and gets changed and all her usual stuff, because she's still going to work. Saving lives on a daily basis, hashtag blessed. She gets up, then I come down a little bit after, help sort out the dog, have some breakfast, chill with a cup of tea whilst Bella sleeps on me for about an hour, go and have a shower and get dressed for the day. So today I'm just wearing a jumper and jeans. Sometimes just be a t-shirt, sometimes it might be. But yeah, that's a bit of an update on what I wear to work and my commute to work. Yeah, so stay safe, stay home, wash your hands, stay gnarly, kids.
So I'll just give you a quick tour. This is the ATCO GT30H. It's the 30th model they've made. Obviously their 30th year at ATCO as a competitor, and it's a two cylinders, possibly four, no one's really sure. British Racing Green, and this is currently with all weather tyres.
Welcome to Ross's Corona Diary. Off to the shops, let's see if the old girl will start in one go.
Not first, last.
you? What day of confinement is it? What do you want?
Hello and welcome to Nash's Quarantine Adventures. It's 2:45. I'm going to take you around my workstation today and how I get to work. So, this is for Bella because she just absolutely darts off otherwise, so we have to have this here. Basically, I come from upstairs, come down, walk in, take corner. Oh, it's the desk there. Me and Sarah said I think I normally have to get on the road by, you know, I think I've left the bedroom by 25 past 8. There's enough time to get down, make a cup of tea, get my breakfast, and get ready to start at 8:30. So it's quite time sensitive. You know, I've really got to be on the ball to get there on time. Here's my work friend. Got Bella, my little work friend. She's been sleeping. Yeah, it's not very exciting. There's my views out here through the blinds. I don't know if you can see. It's not a bad view at all. I had to borrow the desk actually from Sarah's mum because I don't own a desk because I never really get to work from home apart from if it's a race weekend and I just sit with it on my lap because I just can't be asked. So that's makeshift. It's not makeshift, it is an actual desk, it's just a makeshift space. Sometimes I sit on the sofa just to change up scenery. Tomorrow is Friday, so working from home. Then it's the weekend, so I'll be spending that at home. The next week I'm actually off with the 5 days free that we get, which I'll be spending at home. Then it's Easter weekend, which I'll be spending at home. Then working from home the next week, and then there'll be a weekend I'll be at home. So I'm at home now for a lot. You know what, it's not doing anything anyway. Be fucking fuck all to do. Just remember everyone to stay home, Stay safe, wash your hands, and stay gnarly, kids. Peace out.
Morning, welcome to Jessica's Corona Diary.
Nighttime pajamas, daytime pajamas.
Clayton's got herself some juggling balls off Amazon. This is how it's going so far.
Day 5002, going for my first shower.
Whoop. And again. I'm on a bike ride. So I also decided to order myself a Rubik's Cube off Amazon, and first layer done. Day 109, Clayton is reading this book for the fifth time during the entire quarantine, and I'm only on page 26 because I keep forgetting what the bloody book is about, and I'm sunbathing.
Hello? So I thought this is a good one for you, Nixter. On my walk, Mummy has just informed me that this is Stanley Kubrick's old house. You see? Yeah. What's that, Mum? So, local tour guide, Mum. Mummy Lloyd says Stanley Kubrick is still buried in the garden. Hello! Stanley Kubrick is buried in the garden over there, and his wife Christiana apparently still lives in the house. So, there, look. Oh, that's my face. Oh, pretty nice house. That's it, I think. Adios.
Hi, and welcome to Nash's Quarantine Adventures Diaries, which I've realised is about that I've changed every day. Joy is, I'm just cleaning the table.
That's not how I would clean.
So you clean the table, anti back on there. Any germs Sarah might have brought in.
You want to do it in an S motion and wipe down the table.
All done. Now the hard work's done for the day. Just going to get a drink.
There's the fridge.
Very bare fridge. Can I have an innocent guy?
That was my Freddo drawer up there. Full of Freddos, they've all nearly gone.
Innocent Gun. lager. It's a Scottish lager, very nice. Enjoy it very much so. Look at that. Exquisite, some may say.
Can't teach that.
Cheers, Nikki. That's lovely. So it's important when you're at home, you should drink as much as you can to make it bearable. Dog's not happy. So stay safe, stay home, wash your hands, and stay gnarly, kids.
Nikki, it's Ron Jeremy here. I want you to stay gnarly, because you're sexier when you're gnarly. Plus, do you know that the wombat eats roots, shoots, and leaves? You know what that means? Eats roots, shoots, and leaves. Plus, keep this in mind. Dingo ate my baby. Now, you guys want this to be your new theme song, and you'll be very surprised that I can play it. This is Walt St. Matilda, in case you didn't know. Stay gnarly.
Shaq, you don't have to see your face all the time.
Shh. Alexa, turn off my rock lamp lounge.
Hello, I'm Dr. Wiz Khalifa. The COVID-19 pandemic is something that shouldn't be taken lightly. We all have our part to play in beating it. As you see in this video, people all across the world, from Milton Keynes to Sydney, Australia, are all doing their part to help. But that means more than just staying inside and social distancing. It also means preserving vital resources so there's enough for everyone. Panic buying and stockpiling of food and other essential items like toilet paper affects us all and should be stopped. It's also important that we use what resources we have efficiently. Nikki, using one toilet roll a day is an excessive amount. And as a medical doctor, I might suggest that perhaps you need to visit your GP. I hope, Nikki, that you have enjoyed this little movie about people's experience of the COVID-19 virus. Be sure to keep your eye out for COVID-20, the movie, coming later this year. And thanks for watching. Love you and goodbye.